Hi, I'm Stealth, a Tomb Raider speedrunner and streamer, and I'm very excited to bring you this first look showcasing 9 new features in the Tomb Raider Remastered Trilogy. Minimal spoilers ahead, this video contains footage from the first level of each of the 3 main games, but nothing else. The first new feature is Action Indicators. Whenever Lara is close enough to an object to interact with it, there is a new exclamation mark indicator showing that you can press action to interact. This works for items, switches, and other interactable objects such as ziplines. The indicators can be toggled off in the menu if you would rather not see them, but personally, I quite like them, and I think they'll be beneficial when speedrunning. So they introduced some new mechanics to Tomb Raider 1 specifically. The original Tomb Raider 1 did not have a jump twist mechanic, which is where you kind of press roll and she turns around in the air while doing a jump. This has been added to the remaster, as shown. In addition, the way original Tomb Raider 1 works is the running jump is kind of tied to her running animation, so you can only jump at certain points within her running animation. Some players interpret this as it feeling unresponsive or laggy jumping, but in the remasters they've kind of updated Tomb Raider 1 so that it includes the mechanic from Tomb Raider 2 onwards. If you don't know what any of this means, it just means that Tomb Raider 1 jumping will feel more responsive than it did in the original game. The saving mechanic now works in the same way as the PC versions of the original games, where you can make a manual save at any point. This is a change from some of the original console versions. For example, in Tomb Raider 1 on PlayStation 1, you could only save at a save crystal. In addition, the number of save slots has now doubled from 16 to 32 slots. Also, there are no automatic checkpoints, but there is a restart level option if you die, which was previously only available on console and not the PC version. There's not much to explain here. Bosses now have health bars, and regular enemies do not. So for every other clip in this video, I've been using tank controls, which are like the same control scheme as the classic original games, just because that's what I'm used to. However, a new, more modern control scheme can be selected from the menu. That you might prefer, especially those who are new to the classic games and don't have experience with the old classic controls. The new control scheme has a free-moving camera that can be controlled with the mouse or the right analog stick, and Lara handles in a slightly different way. You may not consider this a new feature, but it's one of the things I'm honestly most excited about, so I want to include it on the list. The original games run at a locked 30 frames per second on PC. However, on the remaster, my Steam FPS overlay tells me that the remaster is running at 165 frames per second, which matches the 165Hz refresh rate of my monitor. And it feels so good compared to the original. I really can't exaggerate how good it feels by comparison. I don't know the exact FPS limits for all platforms, but I would expect a minimum 60 frames per second, which is still double that of the original. You may not know that expansion packs were released for each of the 3 original games, and they basically include extra levels and kind of like stand as their own little short game. But they were only released on Mac and PC at the time. With this new release, all 3 expansions have been remastered and brought to console for the first time. They can be selected from the menu when you click New Game. Subtitles have been added, which improves accessibility and allows us to finally stop mishearing the dialogue.
Pardon me. If that was just your way of trying the doors for me.
Leave that Tommy gun on my keyring.
Though not anymore. So after you.
A new photo mode has been added. which I've been using for all the cinematics in this video. I've put the controls to enter this mode on screen. Photo mode allows us to freely move around and rotate the camera, change the field of view, and lets us see many different faces, poses, outfits, and weapons. I will quickly scroll through all of the available options. You may want to pause if you would like to look at each in detail. If you're watching this video soon after it went live, then I'm streaming the remasters right now on Twitch. I'll be looking at the first level of each game and potentially speedrunning them and glitch hunting them. Consider subscribing here on YouTube too, where I hope to be posting more Tomb Raider related videos in the future. Thanks for watching.